see that?
The quiz is there. Welcome. What's your name, please?
It's Elizabeth.
Elizabeth.
Just Elizabeth.
Why have you come on Britain's Got Talent?
Because I want to show you something special and try and make the impossible possible.
Well, the stage is yours, Elizabeth.
Theatres of London's West End. It's said to be haunted by many ghosts. In 1919, the great Harry Houdini appeared on stage and offered a large cash sum for anyone who could prove the existence of them. Amanda, I'd like you to take this journal in your left hand and I'd like you to come with me.
I'm scared.
Legends have said that spirits departed walk the halls and stores of the theatres of London. It is said to be good luck to see ghosts for a performer. For others, not so much.
You look scared.
That's under the stage.
Amanda, please take a seat. These photographs are of people who have lived and died over 100 years ago.
I'm kind of creeped out.
And you hold out your left hand like this. Now, in a moment, I want you to count these photographs face down onto the table, one at a time. When you place them down, you're going to feel a connection to one. When you feel that connection, I want you to stop and to place that photograph face down into this cigar box. Look at the photographs. Each and every one is different, but you were drawn to one and you don't know why.
No.
Open the cigar box and take out the photograph that you chose. Turn it over and read out what it says.
Agatha Turner, 1860.
Before this all began, I gave you a journal that's over 100 years old. Open the page I've bookmarked and read out the paragraph that I've circled in red.
Miss Turner was born in the 1800s. She loved visiting the West End to be entertained. She tragically died in 1860, and her ghost is said to haunt the theatres that she once loved.
Amanda, this moment was always meant to be. Look over your left shoulder.
Oh my God!
Do that.
Oh, going to start crying.
Welcome. Ditto. I presume we aren't going to talk. Okay, that's it. Thank you. Good luck.
At a time we are defined more by our appearance than by within, my identity is not important. It doesn't matter if I am young or old, male or female, or neither. These are strange times. The world we live in is more connected than ever before. However, in many ways, as human beings, we couldn't be more disconnected. But with hope, we will reconnect and realize we are all the same.
We are one.
To demonstrate how powerful we can connect as human beings. I need two individuals who have an undeniable bond.
Dust.
A connection established in 1989, 30 years ago this very year. Can Ant and Death please join me on
this? Okay.
Death. Take a seat to my right.
There.
And please sit to my left.
The wrong way around?
Gentlemen, can you both please close your eyes now? Close your eyes now. You must pay close attention to all sensations you may feel. If you felt a touch, please raise your right hand. Now lower your hands and once again pay close attention to
all sensations.
Sensations. If you felt a touch, raise your right hand.
Huh?
And now point to where you felt that touch.
Oh my God.
This time, remember how many times you feel a touch. If you felt a touch, raise your right hand. And now with your right fingers, show us how many times you felt a touch. Lower your hands and open your eyes now. Your connection is incredible. For the ultimate test of connection, please take a pen each. I also have a board for you both.
For this to possibly work,
let your subconscious minds connect. Begin drawing now. 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. When two people are truly connected, the impossible is possible. Ant and Deck, you may open your eyes. Your connection with each other is truly inspirational. We have just witnessed the ultimate connection.
No way.
An undeniable bond that was established 30 years ago in 1989.
Thank you. Wow. Well done. Wow, that was freaky.
I've been performing magic and hypnosis for many years now.
Oh, yes.
However,
films have been a huge part of my life for many years. Films can influence us in so many different ways. They can make you feel happy, sad, create anxiety, fear, but most of all, surprise. And hopefully, we're going to inspire some of those today. Now, I've got here a deck of cards. Each card has been printed with the name of a different film, as you can see. Taxi Driver, Wall-E, Love Actually, Frozen, etc., etc. Each of the judges is going to have a free choice. David,
yes.
Would you just point to the back of one of the cards for me? This one here. David, do not show Alicia. Very important. Alicia.
Hey.
Would you do me a favour? Would you just point to the back of one of your cards? This one, the top one. Okay, do not show Amanda and do not show David. Amanda, just point to the back of one of your cards. This one here. Do not show Simon and do not show Alicia. And Simon,
yep.
Would you just point to the back of one of the cards? Just point to the back. That one
that
there?
One.
I would like you to take it. Do not let Amanda see.
I won't.
Okay, judges, do you all know the card that you've chosen?
Yes.
You all know the name of that film?
Yes. Yeah.
Most importantly, have you seen those films?
I had to turn down the lead part in this particular movie. It's a true story.
Is it Shrek?
I liked you. You were there so well.
Oh, dear, I'm going to get buzzed on this one, aren't we?
OK, Amanda, this is what I'd like to do. In a few seconds' time, I'm going to ask you to close your eyes. This is very important. Do not open your eyes until I say. Do you understand?
Yes.
Amanda, I'd like you to put your hand out for me like this, your left hand. Good. Close your eyes now. Amanda, keep your eyes closed. Don't say anything. Just really think about the film title.
Oh, my God!
Keep your eyes closed and focus 100% on the name and the title of the film. Amanda, I would like you to open your eyes. What was the name of the film?
Man on Fire.
Wow!
What?
What did he do?
A man walks across the stage on fire.
Simon. You just chose a film.
I know it's going to be. It's going to be Psycho. It's going to be Psycho.
Do you know
Psycho.
The name?
No, wait. It's going to be Grumpy Old Men.
Hey, grumpy look at the hand.
Why?
Sleep.
This is brilliant. Like a blockbuster movie.
Simon, what was the name of your film?
Skyfall.
Skyfall.
Oh, my God.
Alicia. Don't say the film out loud.
Oh, wow!
You thought of The Matrix?
Yes.
Yes!
Finally, David. There was something in here for you, David. This is something that links to your film.
Little Mermaid.
Don't say it, David, but I think this has got something to do with it. Focus on your film right now. Stop! Magic Mike!
I'll just start then.
Just start.
Do you think it would be any good?
No.
Hello! My name's Graham, and it's now time for some magic. And for my magic tonight, I'm going to need a glamorous assistant. Amanda, could you join me on the stage? Let's have a big cheer for Amanda, everybody.
Woo! That big enough for you?
Now, what we're going to do tonight is me and Amanda are going to do some magic. First of all, I'm going to start with a simple magic trick. So I've got some cards here tonight. I've got a birthday card. I've got a wedding card. I've got a get well soon card. I've got welcome to your new home and happy birthday, generic pink. So I'm going to place the cards face down because that's what all the magicians do. What one do you want to go for, Amanda?
This one.
That one. Have a look, Amanda. Lovely. And I will now predict what card Amanda has picked. Amanda?
Yeah?
I've forgotten what one it was. Now... Now, Amanda, I've written a word in the piece of paper just here. Do you know what the word says?
No.
No, that's correct. No. And now I have two cups at the bottom of the water. I'm going to tip water in that cup like that. There's water going in that one. I'm going to tip water in that cup like that. A little bit more in that one. A little bit more in that one. And now, before your very eyes, me and Magic Amanda will make the water disappear. Amanda, if you put the cup on your head like that, Amanda, could you hold that with one hand for me? Trust me, Amanda, I am a magician. So we're going to do the magic water dance. And ladies and gentlemen, the magic water dance will make the water disappear. Let's do this. Yeah. Right. Okay, I'll do the dance first. You go right foot, left foot, you turn around, you face the back, you bend your knees three times, and then you wiggle your bottom three times. Yeah, that made the water disappear. Your turn, off you go. Right foot, left foot, left foot. Turn around, face the back, three knee bends, three bottom wiggles. Give her a big cheer, everybody. The water dance has made the water disappear. Do your cup feel lighter, Amanda?
No.
That's a problem. I'll go first. Here we go. Three, two, one. Yeah! Amanda, trust the magic. I promise you, if you trust the magic and believe in the magic, you will not get wet. Slowly turn it over. Do you want me to sip it over for you? Go, Amanda. Trust the magic, Amanda. That is magic. Ladies and gentlemen, big cheer for Amanda. Wow, you're amazing, Amanda. I don't feel quite so nervous now. Honestly, you've made me happy today. My mum would be ashamed if she knew I was here today. She thinks I'm in prison.
What's your name?
My name is Tomas McKay.
Tomas?
Tomas.
Tomas.
Tomas?
Yeah.
Not Thomas.
No, it's the Irish.
So, Tomas, what do you do for a job at the moment?
I sell beauty days to women.
Beauty days?
Yes.
Do you do any beauty weeks or beauty months? I think a day wouldn't really be enough. Thomas, the stage is yours.
Yes, ladies and gentlemen, I am a mentalist. Today, I'm going to give Amanda Holden a present.
Ah.
I would actually like to ask for the help of Anton Deck, if that's all right.
Yes, you can.
Yes, please.
Deck?
Yes?
I have here a selection of types of gifts. So can you please put both your hands out flat? And we're just going to choose one to just say stop whenever you want.
Stop.
So I'm going to set that there. Deck, can you please turn over that card and read out what you've got?
A toy car.
Now, every gift needs a colour. And if you don't mind, I would like you to reach into this bag of coloured balls, take one out, just hold one ball in your fist.
Got it.
What colour have you got? Blue. We need to make one more choice. Every gift has to have a name. So, Deck,
yep.
Can I just get you to call stop anywhere?
Stop.
Great. Can you just have a look at the first name?
Cody.
So we've got a car, it's blue, and it's called Cody. Now, ladies and gentlemen, there has been a present on this table through the entire act. And
yes.
Can you please take out what's inside? Ladies and gentlemen, I give you... Okay, Amanda, this hasn't gone totally to plan. I do hope you'll forgive me. I will give you this as a little consolation gift. Before I do hand it over, though, Amanda, can I get you to just squeeze its hand and let's hear what it says?
Amanda, look up there.
And if you do look up there, Amanda, your real gift is one blue car called Cody.
Wow.
Yes. Thank you very much, guys.
Oh, God.
Amanda, it was all about you.
It was all about me, so of course I loved it, darling. Do you know what? I think you gave a very confident performance. It all went right. It was all about me. Win-win.
Thank you very much.
Really cool. You actually have something really special about you.
Okay.
Can I keep the bear?
I'll let you keep the bear, yeah.
I'm going to give it to someone.
A lot of children in the world who don't have toys, but your son needs another one. Off with Simon.
I'm going to say yes.
It's a yes from me.
Thank you.
It's a yes from me.
Thomas, it's four yeses.
Thank you so much.
Hello.
That's pretty scary, isn't it?
We are Brotherhood. Welcome to our game of mystery. With this sword.
Yep, that's a sharp sword.
The game is simple. Under one of four boxes will be this sword. We will fall on three of them, not knowing where the sword is hidden. Deck.
Ho-ho-ho-ho-ho. Free yet. Get out there.
Take this sword and place it upright under one of the boxes. We cannot see which box you choose. Our lives are in your hands. As it's Series 13, choose wisely.
Good luck.
Simon, you will decide which boxes we fall onto. Deck, this blindfold will prevent you from seeing which boxes Simon picks. Simon, these four envelopes contain numbers that correspond to each box. You will pick different boxes for each of us to fall onto. As one of the boxes contains the sword, your choice will determine our fate. Brother, stand above your box.
saying that number.
Brother, stand above your box. Simon, you have now chosen our fate.
It's best you don't watch this. And you put a sword there, yeah?
Yes.
I mean, don't try this at home.
Oh, God. Now, before the show, we met some of you, and we asked some of you to stare into a drinking glass and then to visualise an object inside of it. And once you've done that, we asked you to write it down on a single piece of confetti. I can see all sorts of things in here. Someone's written a glass of water, 50-pound notes, that sort of thing. One of these objects will select itself.
I love stuff like this.
Simon, would you read out what's written on that piece of confetti? What object is that?
It's something I don't like.
Okay.
An egg.
An egg? An egg, it is a reminder that everything in our life starts as something smaller. It is fragile, it's perfect. And so all I have to do is visualize that piece of confetti getting heavier. And if you listen, you may be able to hear it. And I have to visualize it changing form. Growing.
What?
Wow.
That's mental.
That's so cool.
Amazing.
Thank you all so much. Now, for this next piece, I will need somebody from the audience. I will take this paper aeroplane, I will throw it out into the audience, one of you will catch it. Coming out over there. See, it soars gracefully. I'm going to get you to unfold that piece of paper for me, where you'll find it's not any old piece of paper. What it is it's a seating plan of this very theatre. Take that piece of paper for me, hold it behind your back. Then I'm going to give you this pen.
Yep.
I'm going to make you take this pen and make a dot or a mark somewhere on the page behind your back so that you don't know where you're going. Do that for me now, just a little dot. Have you done that? Okay, great. Will you have a look? Where did you put your little mark on the paper?
The seat number is L34.
Okay, L34. L34? Is this 34? Hello! What's your name?
My name's Annika.
Annika. Annika, I think you'll be absolutely perfect for this. Are you okay to help me? Okay. Would everybody here give Annika a huge round of applause as she comes on stage? Quick as you can, Annika, follow me. Watch your step on the way up.
These are two autoconductive cages. You can see underneath them, you can see through them, you can see above them. This one's exactly the same. And they're connected in circuit to this Tesla coil. I need you to step up into this cage. Nicely done. Now, Annika, I need you to keep your hands behind your back. Are you ready? Don't worry. And so, all I have to do is to complete the circuit. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1.
I'm James.
My name is Marina.
Are you in a relationship?
Yes, we are.
Boyfriend and girlfriend.
Lovely. And where are you from?
Milton Keynes and Ukraine.
So what you're doing for us today, is this your day job?
Yes, it is.
Do you think you can win?
I think we've got a chance.
Okay. Good luck.
Thank you.
Actually, Anton Deck. Could you join us on stage, please?
Yep.
Thank you.
Yeah.
Could you stand either side of Marina, please?
Yeah, of course.
Can you just have a look in her ears, make sure there's no hidden earpiece or anything like that?
Yep.
No earpiece, nothing there.
Nothing. Please check this sleep mask. Hold it up to your eyes, make sure that you can't see through it.
Nope, not a thing.
Marina, can you put that on, please? Ready? Judges, can I come and join you?
Sure.
Please.
Amanda, if you have things in your handbag, please pull them out now. The more obscure, the better.
Oh.
Marina, will you tell me what this is now?
I think you're holding an item. I think it's a charger, is it?
That is a charger. Remember, Marina can't see. Right, and what's this?
Okay, the next item, I think. Am I correct? Can I almost taste it? It's... Yes, I can smell it now. That's a perfume, and it smells really nice.
Perfume. Thank you so much, guys.
Yes! Wow!
Congratulations.
Wow, well done. Amazing.
Wow. Oh, I get it.
Wow.
I'd like to prove to you now that anybody can do this with the right focus. Amanda, can you come with me and join Marina on stage, please?
Thank you so much for joining me on stage. I have a list of 100 random countries. So can you give me a number between 1 and 100?
97.
Scroll down this list, find number 97, and memorize the country at that number.
Okay.
Thank you, Amanda. Amanda, now, focus on that country, because in a moment, I will touch your forehead just like that. And as soon as I do, close your eyes and say the name of the country in your head, but don't say anything out loud,
okay?
Simon, you have the most difficult job. You're going to be receiving this thought.
Oh, good.
Can you come and stand here next to me, please?
Yep.
When this happens, I also want you to close your eyes.
Okay.
And put your fingers in your ears in such a way that you can't hear anything. That's very important. Then I'm going to touch your forehead here.
Okay.
It's going to be you, your thoughts, and hopefully somebody else's. Simon, put your fingers in your ears and close your eyes now.
Ready? Close your eyes.
Simon, tell me, did you get something?
Yes, I heard something.
You did?
Yeah.
Amazing. Can you please write it on this board?
Amanda, for the first time, what was the country you were trying to send to Simon? Italy.
Totally puzzled by the whole thing.
Now, guys, what you're about to see has never been done on British television before. And the deck, bring it on. Now, what I'm about to do is a trick that I actually invented myself. I never really had the budget to do an amazing illusion, so I decided to make one myself. Amanda, please, could you join me on stage?
That is a cardboard box.
Are you okay with that?
Oh, my goodness.
Nice to meet you, Amanda.
Thank you.
Okay, now what you're about to see is going to blow your mind, okay? And this is a box that I've made myself. I'm going to open it.
I can
it
tell. Oh, Amanda, don't do it.
Take a seat for me.
That's quite narrow, you know.
It'll be fine. You'll get in. Lean back for me. Lean back a bit more. Lean back. You can do it, Amanda. Okay, you're in completely safe hands. And I've also just made something just for you, Amanda, an arm bit. And you can actually move your arm out, put your arm out. We can confirm that's you. Perfect. Okay, now, before we continue, I do need my very special magic wand.
Uh-oh.
And I'm going to show you exactly what that is.
Oh,
this is my magic wand. Amanda, are you ready?
Yep.
More importantly, guys, are you ready?
Yeah!
3, 2, 1, let's do this. Oh, my God. Just like that. And if this has worked correctly, your judge, Amanda, should now be completely...
Will she be able to move them legs?
And can you give your legs a wiggle for me, Amanda? These are your legs.
Oh, my God.
And now, before I put you back together, Amanda, I've got a question for you. Is it a yes or is it a no? What, now, depending on what your answer is, I might not put you back together. So what is it? Is it a yes?
It's a yes from me!
It's a yes, thank you. I thought I was a bit young for you, but thank you so much. I'm going to open this up. Come up for me. Right up, all the way. Your joke. Thank you very much.
Thank you.
Thank you. Return back to your seat. Big round of applause. I'm Daniel Rhodes. Thank you. Good night.
Put your thumbs away. We're going to start at the bottom. We're going to work our way to the top.
Okay.
That's it. And we're going to strap it in the legs like this. That's it. We're going to work it. Have you done this before?
Yes.
Have you? I can tell.
Am I doing it right across your face?
No, we're not going to... Hi.
Are you okay?
Yeah.
A bit nervous?
Yeah.
What's your name?
I'm Alan.
Alan?
Kat.
And are you a couple?
We are husband and wife.
Oh, lovely.
How long have you been married?
Go on, Alan.
Go on.
2.5 years.
Yes, 2.5 years.
Lovely.
Pure bliss, isn't it, Alan?
Yeah.
Pure bliss. And what are you doing for us?
We're doing magic, but we're both doing separate acts.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah. Because we were going to do it together, but we thought, what's better than doing it together? Not doing it together.
we'll start the applause for you.
Go on. Ready?
Hello.
Hello.
What's your name?
I'm Alan Hudson.
Alan Hudson.
And I'm from Hull.
So, Alan, do you have a day job or is this your day job?
This is it. This is all I do. So if you don't like it, I've got nothing else.
So tell us a bit about you.
Yeah, so I've got a wife, and she's watching back here, and she is on Next.
Oh! Wow.
Nah.
Easier warm-up act.
Yeah.
Who's the best out of the two of you, honestly?
Well, I've been doing it longer, but I think my wife is hotter than me and more likable.
Hotter and more likable.
That's the right answer.
Yeah.
The stage is yours, sir.
Thank you very much. So I do comedy and magic, and often people ask me how I got into it, and it's because my parents did it. Well, my mum used to muck about and tell all these silly jokes, and then my dad disappeared. But card tricks, that's what I'm going to do. And usually when magicians do card tricks, they get a card picked, they get it signed, they place it back in the pack, they find it. However, that's what I do as well, so let's get cracking. I'm going to do it twice. First time is going to be great. Second time will be spectacular. Amanda, if you'd like to come and join me on the stage to help with the card trick, big round of applause, Amanda Holder. Amanda, thank you very much for helping.
You're welcome.
If you could put your initials for me nice and big on the card, and maybe like a little symbol as well, nothing rude. Thank you very much. It's going to go into the pack. I'm now going to try and find it using the skills that pay the bills. The funnies that gets me the honeys. Left me hanging, Amanda.
You're right, I'm sorry. I was actually looking at your wife. You're right, she's hotter than
me. She's hotter than me.
Thanks, Amanda.
Here we go. Yeah, spent a lot of time on my own. Four clubs. I mean, it's not Amanda's card, but
it definitely is
the four of clubs.
One,
can you hang on to it for a second?
Yes.
Have another look.
Oh, Alan.
That is a good trick, but it's not spectacular. Now look, I'm not just gonna make it disappear and appear under there, although that is quite good. I'm gonna place it back in the pack. In fact, Amanda, could you place it all the way into the middle for me? Because this time, I'm gonna try and find this card again, but this time without using these, the hands. Because Amanda Holden, off the telly, is gonna tie me up.
For that.
She's watching.
Knock yourself out.
Oh, with cling film.
With cling film.
Are you after a bit of weight loss as well?
Have you? I could. Cheers, mate. Keep your thumbs away. We're going to start at the bottom. We're going to work our way to the top.
Okay.
That's it. And we're going to strap it in the legs like this. That's it. We're going to work it. Have you done this before?
Yes.
Have you? I can tell.
Am I doing it right across your face?
No, we're not going to. And then rip it off at the back for me. Thank you. Here we go. 3, 2, 1.
How did he do that then?
It really is underneath. That really is your sign card.
That's my sign card. Very good.
You can turn back to your seat. Thank you very much for helping.
Oh, very good. You're well, isn't you?
Very well.
Yes, Alan!
Well done.
It was great, yeah. I know. You're a very funny man.
Thanks.
And the tricks are great.
Alicia, what did you think?
Yeah, I think you're naturally very funny.
Thank you.
It was very clever, just very entertaining, so well done.
Thanks.
Loved
Thanks.
It.
I liked it because it was kind of like dishevelled magic. Do you know what I mean? I like the whole act.
Well, based on what we've seen so far in this area, I don't think this is good enough. So I'm going to say no, I'm afraid.
OK.
Well, I very much enjoyed being your Debbie McGee, so I am saying yes.
Thank you.
I'm saying yes.
Thank you. You've just got three yeses, you're through! Now, bring on your hot wife.
I'll go and get her.
Quickly, please. Quick as you can, quicker than that, please, quickly.
Looking at my memory skills, I can tell you that the book that you've chosen is The Lord of the Rings. Can you rip it open and take a look and show everybody?
No, it's The Girl on the Train.
What? That is a little bit embarrassing. David, I totally deserve this. Hello. Hi.
Hey.
Hello.
Hello, Pat.
Hi.
How did you feel Alan did?
I thought he did great. I think he's amazing. I love him.
So, how did you meet?
On a group holiday, and then when I got there, Al was there. He started sending me some card tricks, well, that's all right, isn't it? And there you go. And now he's, like, totally changed my life.
Aww.
This is what I do.
I love it.
Kat?
Yes, that's me.
The sage is yours.
Thank you. Before I start, do you mind if I just...
No, girl, you
take this off. It's not that kind of act, but it's just a little bit, just a little bit warm.
Yes! Yes!
I'm feeling much better now, thanks. So I'm a magician, and I'm going to demonstrate for you a set of skills that have taken me a lifetime to learn. Simon, I'm going to leave that there. I've heard that you like a beer, so feel free to take a swig. David.
Hi.
Hello. I am going to get you to choose a book. Okay?
A book.
Now, if I said name any book...
Oh, come on.
Let's be honest, you'd probably just choose your own.
I would,
and
yeah.
Why wouldn't you? Bit of advertising. We'd all do it, wouldn't we? So, I've got 20 books with me today.
OK, so one of those books.
They are all different, they are all wrapped, and they're all in a random order. Can you just give me a number between 1 and 20?
7.
Number 7. Good choice. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Now, before you open it, if you'd have chosen the one before it, you would have picked One Day. Ooh. And if you'd have chosen the one after it, you'd have picked Matt Lucas. He's a funny guy, isn't he?
He was always the funny one.
Thank you. Before you open it, using my memory skills, I can tell you that the book that you've chosen is The Lord of the Rings. Can you rip it open and take a look and show everybody?
No, it's The Girl on the Train.
What? That is a little bit embarrassing. David, I totally deserve this. That's good.
I love that you buzzed yourself.
Alicia.
Yes.
I have got a bag of CDs here.
Okay.
That my mum got me from the market, you know. You know,
right.
Look after the pennies.
Mm-hmm.
Stuff like The Jam, The Hoosiers, Beautiful South.
Uh-huh.
I'm going to pop them in there. I'm going to give the bag a little shake. I would like you to reach inside, take one out, hold it towards you, don't show me what it is.
Okay.
Perfect, okay, don't show me.
Okay.
Amanda.
Yes.
My mum's been busy at the market. I've got DVDs this time. I love a bargain. I've got Dexter, The Crown, Gavin and Stacey. Can you just reach inside, take one out, take a look at it, don't show me. I'll avert my eyes. Okay. Now, using my mind reading skills, I want you to think of the CD, I want you to think of the DVD. Are you ready? Oh, I've got it. Mr. Brightside, Peaky Blinders.
Absolutely not.
No. Oh.
Really?
Really.
No. What have you chosen?
I Bet You Look Good on the Dance Floor, Arctic Monkeys.
And what have you got?
I love this one, Killing Eve.
Killing It, that is a good
love
one, isn't
Killing
it?
Killing Eve.
But, I mean, I was not even close.
No.
Simon, there is one puzzle left. I am going to save you the job, don't you worry. That's a bit weird. But I can see why it's not working. There is a piece of paper wedged underneath it. Can you reach round, take it out, and take a look at it?
Yeah. So open it.
Open it up.
It says, look at the screen.
Everybody, look at the screen.
Roger Moore.
This is filmed earlier today. This is you guys arriving. Now, if you look at the poster, you all had a completely free choice. The title of the show is The Girl on the Whole Train. The girl on the train is what David chose. The tagline is Have a Killing Evening. Killing Eve, that is what Amanda chose.
Yes!
And out of all the songs, the song that I am listening to on my phone is The Arctic Monkeys, I Bet You Look Good on the Dance Floor.
Nice.
And that, my friends, is a miracle.
What?
But that's not it.
What?
Just in case you think I've got a tech whiz backstage that has just knocked that up, which, ridiculous, that didn't happen. That beer has been sitting there the full time.
Yeah, I had a sip.
Before I brought it out, I had some words engraved onto the glass. Can you now pick up the glass and read out loud what it says?
Killing Eve, girl on the train, you look good on the dance floor.
Thank you. And that, my friend, is a miracle. Thank you. Thank you very much. Thank you so much.
Wow.
Yes.
Thank you. I feel like when you're done.
That was incredible.
Thank you.
It was superb. And I like that you're just completely you. It was brilliant from start to finish. Very, very original.
Yeah. Thank you.
Very enjoyable.
Like David said, you're just really normal, really cool girl, so you made the whole thing very relaxed. Yeah, I really hope you go far in the competition.
You do. It's true. Just the whole thing felt so authentic. I really enjoyed it.
Oh, thank you.
You did an ace job. It was brilliant.
Thanks.
For me, the end of the magic act is when you're like, what? And that's what we all did.
Mm.
And that's why, out of the two, you were by far the best. David?
I'm saying yes.
Oh, thank you.
It's a yes from me.
Thank you.
Definite yes from me.
Oh, thank you.
Kat, you got four yeses.
Yeah! Thank you so much. Thank you.
She's just a cool girl. She's the sort of girl I'd like to go for a drink with.
Well done. You bought through. Thrilled for you.
A great night for the Hudsons.
Yeah.
I can go and have a beer now.
Yeah.
Beer.
Go on.
I'm not a mind reader, but I have some friends who are.
Oh.
Let's see if they're going to join us. And here they are. So, have a look. I brought a dice and a cup.
Yep.
You want to roll the dice a few times?
Yep.
You should get a different number every time.
Just keep doing that.
You can just roll it to make sure it's not weighted or, yeah?
Yep.
Want to do it again to make sure?
Just a real dice.
Now, I'm going to need some help. Wonderful.
Five.
We're going to do an experiment. Would you mind helping with that?
Okay.
Can you put the dice into the cup and cover the cup with your hand and give it a good shake? Then turn the cup over onto the table. Fantastic. Now, in a moment, I'm going to turn around, and I want you to peek at the dice. If you're happy with the number you see, you keep that number, but you can also change it. And don't let the others see the number, okay? I'm going to turn around. Do it now.
Okay.
Is the dice covered again?
Yes.
Fantastic. Would you mind joining me on stage?
Oh.
Yeah.
Do I leave it like
it's
that?
It's going to get a little bigger. Come on up.
I'm on top of the pops with this dry eye.
We're going to go right in the middle
top
here.
Of the pops.
And we're going to face the audience just a little further back. You're the only person now who knows that number on the dice. I'm not a mind reader, but I have some friends who are.
Oh.
Let's see if they're going to join us. We live in a world of unparalleled surveillance. It's the world of Black Mirror, where our every move is followed. But imagine if we could not only access our location and our identity, but also our thoughts. There are 6 numbers on a dice. There are 15 drones observing the micro expressions on your face as I'm gonna call out those numbers.
Okay.
Ready? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Simon, can you lift the cup and reveal the number?
3.
You wanna turn around? We have the 3 dots in red.
Wow!
And that's your number you're thinking of? Fantastic, come on, let's get out of here. Thank you very much, thank you.
Magic drones!
Time to go home, everybody. Time to go home.
Roll them into the basket?
They were little starstruck, sorry, Simon. You wanna take a bow? There you go, and time to go home.
Brilliant!
And that's it. Thank you very much.
Bring your knees. Knees. Take a bunch of flowers and put them under your arm. Take another bunch of flowers and put them under your other arm.
Hello there.
Who are you?
My name's Ant.
Would you like your photograph taken with me?
I would, but we've got an audition to do.
All right.
What's your name?
Roger Fabulous.
Hello, Roger, Roger Fabulous. What a fabulous name,
and your
Roger.
Name is?
I'm Deck.
Oh, Deck.
I'm the good-looking one.
I do card trick, Deck.
Do you?
Yeah.
With a card deck?
Deck.
With a deck of cards?
Yes. Yeah. I like your bag, Roger Fabulous.
Well, it's for you, Deck.
Okay.
You need to do something with this bag.
So I'm in it? I'm in the act?
Yeah.
Am I in it?
I'll give you a kiss. No.
You're not in it.
Okay.
Unfortunate, that's okay. Unfortunate.
Nothing I can do?
No, feelings. It just that it suits the size of you and everything to do with the... And you're so handsome.
Thank you.
Hello.
Hello.
Welcome, and what's your name?
My name's Roger Fabulous.
But it says there, Trump-dini.
Well, he's arriving shortly.
Oh, okay, God, okay, I shouldn't have asked that. So tell me about you.
Well, I'm a magician.
Great.
Yeah, I don't really do it for the money. I'm not trying to be flash.
You wouldn't mind the money?
Well, I don't need any more, to be honest. I'm still trying to catch up with you, but, you know, does it matter?
You can only eat 3 meals a day, Roger.
Yes, yeah. You can. You can only eat once.
That's very true.
I like to eat 5.
Well, we can see that.
Whoa. I really like you. I really like you, Roger. Okay, I'm not going to ask any more questions, so good luck.
Thank you.
Yeah, really good luck, Roger.
Thank you. Thank you. This is Trump-dini. Glad to sit down, Trump-dini. He's very tired, he's jet-lagged, and he's been trying to practice this card trick all over the Atlantic, and he still can't baffle it out. So he's asked me, before he does this trick, would I do mine? Would you like to see it? Now, you've got to be very, very observant with this trick. I do these on... This is ideal for saga cruises. Now, the idea is you've got to watch the Queen. Where is the Queen? In the middle. Queen's in the middle. Now, you see, you weren't paying attention because that's the Queen and that's the King. And that's the King. So the Queen's in the middle.
You might not even get on at this race.
Oh, that'd be good, wouldn't it?
Right, now I'll give you one more chance. There's the King. And then we'll put that there. And there's the Queen there. I'll put that there. and I put that queen there and that king there. Now, which one do you think? Who thinks it's this one? Who thinks it's the one in the middle? Who thinks it's this one? All queens. Thank you. I'd like to do the Trumdini card trick now, and I'd like somebody to come and pick a card.
Yes, you're on. Take the bag.
To me?
So, yes, if you could, yes.
Declan Dudley!
Pick a card.
Yay! Hey. You know, Dick.
I'd like you to just stand over there, please. And these are the instructions for the Trumdini card trick, which you'll find amazing. Oh, yes, you will. Take a small diamond ring, yes, and put it between your knees. Stand up.
Between my knees?
Between your knees. Knees. Take a bunch of flowers and put them under your arm. Take another bunch of flowers and put them under your other arm.
Brilliant.
Deck will turn Trumdini's head round so he can't see the card. This table is far too far away for you, and I'm going to move it over here a bit nearer for you. I'll try and get this table. Now you've got to pick a card.
What?
Roger, look, you got four no's, so that means it's a no, but thank you very much. Cheers.
Buzzed off at the London Palladium. How do you feel?
It's the worst moment of my life.
I knew you were going to do that, but that's not it. It's not it. Alicia, at the bottom of your message, there is a little shape. There
yes.
is one on everybody's. Alicia, what shape do you have? Over the last few years, I've been watching Britain's Got Talent, and I think I know how you think as judges.
Oh, God.
So I'm going to ask you to help me out, and by joining in, we are going to create something amazing.
Great.
Simon.
Yes.
Behind you is one of our wonderful stage crew. He's got four lanyards just there.
Hello.
They're numbered 1, 2, 3, and 4.
Yep.
Which one would you like?
I'll take number one, please.
Number one. I'm going to give you a chance to change your mind.
No, I like one.
Number one, okay. Yeah. So if you could pop number one on for me, that would be great. Amanda, you have
yes.
the choice of 2, 3, and 4. Which would you like?
I'm going to go 4.
Number 4. Again, I'm going to give you a chance to change your mind.
4's fine.
4 is perfect.
Thank
then you.
You
have number 4 lanyard. It is going to go great with a dress, Amanda. Perfect. Alicia.
Hello.
Hi, my love.
Which would you like?
2, please.
Number 2. Okay, again, change your mind or no?
No, I'm fine with that.
You're happy with number 2. Okay, then number 2 is for yours just there. David, I'm sorry, you don't get a choice. You just get number 3. Apologies for that. Perfect. I have a second choice for everybody as well. I have some colours, red, yellow, green, and blue. Each of these pieces of paper have a direction for switching seats with somebody else. Simon. You get the first choice again. Red, yellow, green, and blue. Which one would you like?
I'll take green, please.
The green one. Okay, I will give you a chance to change your mind before we look at
no,
it.
No, I like green.
You like green?
Yeah.
Okay, perfect. Then I'm going to ask you to change places with Amanda.
This is
Beautiful.
My rightful place.
Excellent. Amanda, don't get comfy
waited
because you're going to choose
years.
Next.
I've waited for years. I can just sit down and feel what it's like.
So, red, yellow, or blue, Amanda?
Yellow.
Again, I'll give you a chance to change your mind.
Okay, actually, no, I'm going to go blue.
You're going to change to blue?
Yes.
Okay, wonderful. Then, Amanda, I'm going to ask you to change places with David.
Down.
All the way down the end. Perfect. David now gets to sit in Simon's seat.
Whoopee.
Sorry, Simon.
Yeah, thanks
Alicia,
for that.
While they're switching, we have
thanks,
red,
Amanda.
We have yellow left. Which would you like?
Yellow's my daughter's favourite colour, but red is...
Oh.
I'll go with red.
You're going to go with red?
Yes.
I will give you a chance to change your mind.
No, I'll stick with red.
So you're going to stick with red.
Yeah.
OK, so I'm going to ask you to change places with Simon.
Oh.
One more time. Beautiful.
I like this game.
Excellent. Okay, and of course, David, would you like yellow or yellow?
I think I'll go for the yellow.
Oh, yellow. Then you are changing places with Alicia.
It's a bit damp.
Beautiful.
I always knew I should be in this chair.
All four of you have changed places with each other. There is no way we could know which order you would be sat in now. But before we started, I had four messages placed on the back of your chairs.
Uh-huh.
They're Velcroed on. If you want to reach behind and just take them off for me. Alicia, we're going to start with you. Read out what it says on your message.
It says Alicia will be sat in Simon's chair.
And you are sat in Simon's chair, correct?
Yeah.
David, read yours.
David will be sat in Amanda's chair.
Perfect, Simon.
I'm going to be sat in Alicia's chair.
You're sat in Alicia's chair, and Amanda
will be sat in David's chair.
And Amanda will be sat in David's chair. Perfect. Very good. I knew you were going to do that, but that's not it. It's not it. Alicia, at the bottom of your message, there is a little shape. There
yes.
is one on everybody's. Alicia, what shape do you have?
I have a star.
You have a star. Right at the beginning, I asked you to choose a lanyard each.
Yes.
Alicia, if you look down on your lanyard, at the bottom of your lanyard, on the other side, there is a little yellow bar. If you just pull it down towards you, you will reveal a shape, and it is...
A star.
A star, perfect. David, what shape do you have on your message?
I have a triangle on my message.
And just pull down on your lanyard, and you have a...
I have a triangle.
You have a triangle, Simon. You have a circle, and on the bottom of your thing is a circle. And finally, Amanda, pull it down for us. Amanda, turn it round so we can see the lanyard on the other side. It is a square, ladies and gentlemen. Fantastic. That is good.
Very clever.
Very good.
How have you done that?
Wow.
You each had the chance to change places. You each had the chance to choose different lanyards.
Yes.
And you did this. And like I said, I knew what you were going to do. It had to finish like this, because the answer has been right in front of you this entire time. In seat order on my T-shirt is a star with an A for Alicia in it. Here's David's triangle with a D in it. Simon, this is your S. And Amanda, this is your square.
Wow.
It's amazing. Thank you very much.
Boom.
And I don't know about you, at the end of the week, I have more cash receipts than money. Who has the same problem? It doesn't really matter, because you can take these as well, say the magic words, inland revenue. I had to do that. It costs £120. As you know, the English are famous for their excellent cuisine. Fish and chips, sausage and chips, chicken and chicks, sorry, chicken tikka masala, chicken wings and chips. They're a bit dry in London, but I eat them anyway. And I was in a fine food store in London and bought this. Organic tomato ketchup, established 1869. Yes, that was a good year for tomatoes. I'm going to try and... I don't know about you, but in Germany, they recycle absolutely everything. In England, we only recycle the royals. And I'm going to try and recycle the ketchup without my hands leaving my arms. This is so amazing, I'm going to watch it myself. Say the magic words. Britain's got tomatoes. You won't believe how long it took me to find a tomato cup. Oh, recycling, very important.
Now that was good. Let me do it.
Don't know if you've seen these magicians that come on stages and they have these burning wallets. Hang on. Fire pressure. And I don't know about you, at the end of the week, I have more cash receipts than money. Who has the same problem? It doesn't really matter, because you can take these as well. Say the magic words, inland revenue. I was told that, David, you have some money that you can lend me. Could you come up onto the stage and you get a big round of applause?
I have a £10 note.
A £10 note, that should be all right. Could you sign your initials on the note, please?
Yeah.
If you can stand over here, just above the trap door underneath the sandbag.
There you go.
David, do you believe in Japanese paper...
Origami?
No, Japanese paper folding, oregano. Obviously not. Oh, no. I'm sorry, we've got a cash receipt for £1.50, but hang on, we'll sort that one out. David, £1.50, you were kind enough to lend me £10, plus £2.50, plus £15.30. You can keep the change, David. Now, you're probably wondering where that little note has gone to. So, David, here you go. If you can just put that on.
On my hand?
Yeah, on your hand.
You never know.
Grab the tomato. Do you have a Swiss Army knife on you?
No.
A British Army knife on you?
No.
An Austrian Army knife?
Oh, okay.
Can you check the knife? I will cut open the tomato at the equator. Just a...
That is my...
That's his note. Thank you very much. Thank you very much.
You're a fine magician. Thank you very much.
Thank you. Good night.
1746. 5, 4, 3. The phone goes back 9 minutes to 5:37.
What?
Hello, Sean.
How are we doing?
How are you? All right?
Yeah, wonderful. Good. Thanks
Hello,
so
mate.
Much.
Nice to meet you.
Yeah, and you as well. Yeah.
How are we doing?
Excellent.
Pack of cards, bit of magic.
Pack of cards, a bit of magic.
Great.
Yes.
Right. Fantastic.
But before I go on, I need to place one of the cards the wrong way around in the pack. Just like this.
Okay. Yeah. Right. Did you get that? Got that on camera?
So far, so good.
That was good.
All yours. Have fun out there.
Thank you.
Right.
Hello. How are you doing?
I'm good, how are you?
Very good, thank you.
What's your name?
My name's Sean.
Sean, where are you from?
I live in Northampton.
Okay. How old are you?
I'm 36.
Who have you come with?
I've come with my girlfriend, Melinda, somewhere. I don't know. There she is.
She's over there. That's good, she still wants to know you. That's a good start. So you're a magician?
Yes.
How long have you been doing magic?
I've been doing magic since I was about 6 years old. And, I've just become completely fascinated with it. Got a job when I left school at a biscuit factory. And then finally...
Which one?
Called Foster's Foods in Market Harborough.
What's your favourite biscuit?
My favourite biscuit? I like a good bourbon.
I like a bourbon.
Yeah. I was thinking bourbon.
No. Good old rich tea.
Well, this is fascinating.
Good luck.
Can I come down and see?
Oh. Yeah.
So, when I was backstage with Ant and Deck, I placed one card the wrong way around in the pack, just here. Simon, I'm going to ask you to please just think of any playing card. Don't tell me.
Yeah,
Make sure it's not an ace. So I don't want it to be an obvious one.
I've got it.
You have one?
Yep.
And at the end of this trick, the card that Simon is thinking of is going to be this card here, the card that's the wrong way round in the pack.
Okay.
But before we start, we need to make this a little bit more random. David, can you take this packet of cards? I want you to mix the cards, but in a really random way. Not just shuffle them normal, shuffle them face up and face down like this, however you want to do it. Alicia, please do the same. Amanda, here's some for you as well. And Simon, if you could please shuffle these face up, face down, in any way that you like. Perfect. And judges, I'll take them back. Thank you very much. Thank you, Alicia. Thank you, David. Thank you, Amanda.
Thank you, Simon.
Thank you. Now, I'm going to ask you to do just one more thing for me. I want you to take out your phones, if you have one, with you. I just place some screen down on the table. Oops. Okay. Now, Simon, at the beginning of the trick, you thought of a card.
Yes, I did.
You see these cards are in a right mess now, all the way through the pack. Simon, for the first time, what I'm going to ask you to do is please just name the card that you were thinking of.
It was the Two of Diamonds.
The Two of Diamonds.
Yeah.
Alicia, please hold out one hand for me, please. I'm going to put the cards on top, put your other hand on top like this. Now, I've probably been on this stage maybe more than 3 minutes, but less than 10. In order to fix this problem, I need to go back in time. Amanda, can you please tell me a number higher than 3, but lower than 10?
9.
We're going to go back in time just 9 minutes. Please keep your eye on the time on the phone just here. 1746, 5, 4, 3. The phone goes back 9 minutes to 5:37.
What?
But not just on my phone, can I?
Yeah. What?
No.
But not just on the judges' phones. On every phone in this audience goes back to 5:37.
Look!
So, yes.
Look at that!
Yes.
And all your phones say 5:37.
Yeah, look!
Whoa. Oh my God.
How has he done that?
Oh, the blinking egg, did you do that?
Simon. At the beginning of the magic, Simon, I asked you to think of just one card.
Yes, I did.
It was a Two of Diamonds, did you say?
Yes, it was.
Alicia, please, may I take these cards back?
Yeah.
Thank you. In order for this to work, I had to go back in time. And when I went back in time, when I was standing back there with Ant and Dec, all the cards were the correct way round, apart from this card just here. Simon, it's the Two of Diamonds. Thank you.
That's brilliant.
Thank you very much. Thank you so much.
Magic is real.
Amazing.
What a time shot.
David.
Wow.
Thank you.
That was something special. I loved it. Because just as we thought it was all going to be about, you know, doing card magic, became something else entirely. And we're always saying what we want on this show is to create a moment, you know. And it was an amazing moment where everyone's looking at their phones going, how did he do that? It was brilliant. It was brilliant. Well done.
Alicia.
Yes, I'm not normally a fan of card magic, but I liked your presentation, like the way you put everything together. It was a good audition. Well
done. Thank you very much, Alicia.
Absolutely. You started out a little bit nervous, but you kind of got more confident as time went on and, you know, you suspended our disbelief and created that moment and the entire audience was behind you. So,
thank you.
Well done.
It wasn't a question of suspending your disbelief. He made everybody's clocks go backwards. So that's not suspending disbelief, that's magic.
That's turning back time.
Yes, it's turning back time.
You look younger.
I do. It's amazing what you just did.
Well, thank you so, so much.
Seriously, amazing.
Thank you.
Should we take a vote?
Yes.
David?
Let me kick this off with a yes.
It's a yes for me.
It's a yes for me.
Well, obviously, it's a yes. I just don't know where I am right now in the world, thanks to you. But brilliant. I
Thank
believe
you very
in magic.
Much.
I love it.
Brilliant.
Well done, Sean.
Thank you very much.
Happy?
Happy, yes. Don't know what to do. I'm shaking.
Oh,
like mad.
Well done, brilliant.
Thank you
well
so
done.
Much.
That was
thank
incredible.
You so
I have to reset the clock on my phone now,
yeah,
thanks
well,
to you.
Yeah, say we're all younger now, aren't we?
Yeah, by 9 minutes.
Well done, well done.
Thank you so much.
Nice brilliant.
We're in the past, guys. We're in the past. We're 9 minutes in the past, right?
Whatever.
This card can travel through the time. Now everything go back to the very beginning.
Bill Chung. Nice to meet you, Bill. Meet my friend, Jack.
Bill Chung. Good to see you too. Nice to meet you. Thank you for coming.
Where are you from?
I'm from Austria.
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 Yes.
Oh, wow. And why did you decide to come to Britain's Got Talent?
This is the best stage. This is my dream space stage.
Really?
To see that. Go on,
I'm just fooling my dream.
But this is the best.
Yes, this is the best stage.
Best stage.
Yeah, of course. Best stage.
Best stage.
The best.
Not our words, the words of Bill Chung.
And the best hosts. Did you say that?
Best host. Yeah, best host.
Yes, thank you, Bill. That. That's very kind
well,
of you.
Well done, Bill.
That's
kind of you to offer that up. Okay, we're ready for you.
Let's go.
Bill, it's all yours. Have fun out there.
Okay, thank you.
Hello, thank you.
Hello.
Wow, I love Britain Crown.
Hi.
Hi.
How are you?
I'm good. I'm doing good. Thank you. My name is Bill Chung. I will be doing magic tonight.
Oh.
Lovely.
Yeah.
Yes, magician.
Where are you from?
I'm from Austria. I'm a Chinese living in Vienna.
Love it. How old are you, please?
I'm 37.
37?
Yeah.
Okay. We wish you the best of luck. Go for it.
Thank you very much. I would like to invite a judge to come and join me in the show. Amanda, are you available now?
Amanda or...?
Amanda, are you available?
Am I available? Let me just check my diary.
Thank you.
Let's give her a round of applause.
Take your seat. This experience is about time travel. In the glass, we have a brand new deck of cards. It's still sealed. It's brand new. Please touch it. Check it out. It's still sealed.
It feels new.
Yeah, it's new deck. No, new deck of cards. You can see all the cards in new deck order, right? Can you see it?
Yeah.
Now, would you please shuffle the deck for me? It's a new deck of cards, right?
New deck.
It's
very
brand new.
New.
Yes.
It's new.
You're sure, right?
I'm so sure it's new. Yes.
Perfect. Thank you very much, Amanda. Now, I will do like this, show you all the cards different, and you can tell me anywhere stop you want, just anywhere you want.
Stop there.
Really?
Yeah.
You sure? Okay. So I show you the card.
Okay.
Seven of diamonds, right? Would you please sign them for me? Make a big special signatures on the face of the card, the seven of diamonds, yes. Perfect. Perfect. Now this card is a magic. This card has a very special abilities. This card can travel through the space. You can see the face of the card, right? You can see the back of the card. The seven of diamonds. Watch, the seven of diamonds jump from one side to another. It traveled. Oh, thank you. This card not only travels through the space, you can see, now the two Joker is gone. Wait a moment. And this card can travel through the time. Now everything go back to the very beginning. The story begins with a brand new deck of cards. So in the glass, We have a brand new deck of cards. Please check it out.
Take yes,
it
they're out. New. They are.
Yeah, check it out.
They're new. There's a seal and they're very yeah. new. They are.
Very new.
They're very new, Bill.
Perfect. I hope so. No, a new deck of cards normally begin with
two jokers.
Two jokers.
Yes.
Let me see. And falling with ace of kings. Ace of kings, right? I can see two jokers. Falling with ace to kings. Ace to kings, you stop anywhere. There's only one card in between the six of diamonds and the eight of diamonds. No There's way. Only one card.
No way.
Face down. Do you still remember? You put a signature on it, right?
Mm-hmm.
This is only one card with your signatures. Please check it out. Is it your signature?
That's my signature.
Yes. Thank you very much.
That's my card.
Wait a moment, wait. You can see all the cards back in new deck order, the red deck of cards, right, in new deck order from mm-hmm. ace to kings. But before you shuffle the deck, before we open the deck, even before it's printed, it's only some piece of blank papers on both sides. You can see on both sides some blank piece. Papers. I still remember you signed the one card.
I did sign it.
The seven of diamonds. But before you signed it, before you tell me stop, even before I open the deck, before the deck printed, it is only a piece of blanco. Papers.
What? What?
Check it out. Thank you so much. I hope you enjoy my illusion. Thank you. Wow. Thank you so much.
Amazing. Amazing.
Thanks.
Amazing.
I got it though.
Wow.
Well done, Bill.
Thank you so much.
Amanda, what did you think?
Well, it was extraordinary because obviously I was right there and I couldn't see anything. I couldn't see what you were doing. I was certain that every single package was a new package. So it was a very clever, it was very magical. Yes, it was magic.
Thank you so much.
David?
Yeah, I think you're a brilliant character. It's obviously. This is close-up magic, and we actually couldn't be further away from you. You're obviously superb at what you do. I just can't wait to watch this on TV.
Simon, what did you think?
I think you're really, really talented. But going forward, what would be the next stage?
I would like to have a headline show in Las Vegas. I will work hard because my passion, I love magic.
Yes. So I think what Simon's trying to say is we get a lot of magicians
mm-hmm,
that do card tricks. And yeah. I think, you know, we just want to see something fresh and new, which I'm sure you can do.
Definitely.
I love your quirky little personality. You're very cute.
Yeah, cute. You are cute.
He is cute.
Right, can we vote?
We shall.
David? You're such a little cutie. I'm going to say yes.
Bill, I'm going to say yes.
It's a yes for
Thank
me.
Thank you.
No cards.
No cards.
Yay!
Definitely four yeses. No well done.
Thank you very much. I love you guys.
Okay. Does anyone have sunglasses right now?
I do.
All right, Grace, would you mind if I borrow?
What's your bringing sunglasses to work for?
Because she's a star.
Oh, okay.
Cool, Thank right? you.
That's it, you never see him again.
I'd hit it for him.
You found a whole new way of presenting magic, and you've just got a real star quality.
Thank you.
It was super cool. You look amazing. Your sleight of hand and everything is just impeccable.
Thank
you. So well done.
Thank you so much.
Simon, what did you think?
I think you are brilliant.
Thank
and
you.
Your stage presence is sensational. It's one of the best magicians we've seen all year.
Wow.
Really?
Thank you.
Yeah, that was so slick. Choreographed to perfection. Definitely want to see more from you.
Thank
Brilliant
you.
Brilliant audition. So I'm going to kick this off with a yes.
I'm saying yes.
I'm saying yes.
I'm actually going to say yes.
Warning, scary act.
I don't like it.
Between the dark and the light, the good and evil, which will you choose?
Oh, dear.
Oh, no,
they're done.
Oh, no, is it coming out? I don't like it.
Don't come down here.
Careful, Simon.
Two pathways for you, David.
Yes.
Which do you choose? Take an apple. Take a bite.
Mmm. It's nice.
Mmm. Your turn, Alicia. Between the good and the evil, which will you choose? Take an apple. Bitey bite. It's something I've got to tell you, but it can wait. It can wait. Amanda, stand up.
Oh gosh, it's always me.
Put your hands out. Face up. Come closer. Come closer. Your destiny will be chosen by another.
Oh, God.
We between the dark and the light. Only choose. Left or right? Louder!
Right.
Who's right, though?
My right! Take a bite. Amanda, you know why they say the beauty's only skin deep? Because we're all rotten to the core.
Okay, well, that was horrific. And the witch has turned into a cockroach. So we're gonna have to talk to them.
I mean, I was scared to death. I mean, I'd quite like to see what else was gonna happen.
I'm with you.
In the future.
Alicia, what do you think?
I thought the act was actually brilliant.
David.
I thought it was stunning. So I think we should vote, and let me kick this off with a yes!
I'm saying yes!
Amanda.
It's a yes from me.
We want to see you in the next round. I don't know how you did that. Maybe we'll see you in the finals. Congratulations.
It's freaking me out. Did I come back? He and she?
I don't know.
How do you think he got Italy?
Hello.
Hello. Hi.
What's your name?
My name is Keiji Iwasaki.
Where are you from?
I'm from Japan.
Oh, I love Japan.
Ah, thank you so much.
Watashi wa arigatou.
Oh, yes, exactly.
Yes.
Oh, this
that's all I know. how old are you?
Yeah, I'm 49 years old.
And what you're doing for us today, is that your day job?
No, it's my bicycle and... No. Sorry. Pardon. I'm a little bit nervous, so excuse me.
No worries, my darling. So why Britain's Got Talent?
It's because a big state, the biggest state in the world, then it's like one of my dreams to come here.
Oh, fantastic.
Yes, it's amazing.
Wow, it's a pleasure to have you.
Yeah.
And what would you do with the money if you were to win?
I want to across the Atlantic Ocean by rowing boat. So
yes.
Then I want to buy the boat.
Oh, fabulous.
You didn't expect that answer, did you?
No one's ever said that.
I love that. Yeah.
Okay, well, whenever you're ready.
Yes.
Go for it.
Okay. Now I start.
Yeah. Oh my God, I love him.
I'm laughing already.
Simon, hello.
Hello.
How are you? Because 100 times I saw you in YouTube. Simon, do you know this one?
Chopstick.
Yes, chopstick. One, two, three. Sorry. One more time. Just this.
What did you just do?
It's not the magic, I'm joking. Let's start the magic.
He's good. He's funny.
Then maybe ask the Deccan the aunt.
Deccan
yes!
Deccan the aunt!
Deccan aunt, bro! Deccan aunt! That's got a ring to it.
It's aunt and deck.
No, Deccan aunt.
Aunt and deck it is.
Aunt
and deck. Yeah, that's right.
Please check this card is normal.
Normal.
Normal. And please shuffle it.
Of course.
Yes,
very well. Deck shuffle the deck.
Deck
shuffled.
Yes,
by
perfect.
Deccanant.
Yes. could take on that as you like.
Me?
Yeah, no, next to that.
Still
okay.
Me.
No. Okay, please show everybody. I don't see it. I don't want to see it. Okay, please show the audience.
No, I'm doing this bit.
Okay, may I put it here? And I just scroll. Now I show the Japanese way to shuffling. Okay, wada. Here, your card is wada. There. The queen, this or this?
No.
That's not okay. This one?
No.
This. No. What? Just here. It's okay. Is your card?
Yes. Yeah. Wow.
How do you put the card in the man's armpit?
No, I put. Just move. Hop. Whoa. Stop. Let's hop. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9.
Amazing.
Oh. Didn't know Japan was creating wizards. What's going on over here?
£20. And do you want it?
No.
I put here £20. Hop. What? It's like a going to move an area of this nature. Now, what? Excuse me, energy finished. But no problem. Genki dama! My last trick is for ladies.
For ladies?
Yes. Alicia, do you come over here?
I come over here.
Well,
you didn't do an awful lot then, did you?
He didn't ask us to, did he?
Alicia, what? Okay, arigato. Please check this is what? What is this?
It's a ring.
It's a ring, yes. Give me a finger like this. I put the ring here, okay? Just hold on, don't move, because it's a very difficult magic. This ring, your finger. Hat. 1, 2, 3. All star passing. Whoa! I said, wait, hold on. Hat. 1.
You are very, very charming, and your magic was absolutely excellent.
Yes.
I mean, faultless.
So much. It's too much.
You're the funniest person we've seen and the most magical person we've seen, all combined in one, and I love you.
Yes, thank you so much.
You are an absolute natural. People are going to like you so much.
Thank you so much.
My son is going to love you. I mean, love you. You are one of the best we've seen so far.
Isn't that lovely?
Yes, thank you so much.
The audience love you. I love you too. You're a superstar, so I'm going to kick this off with a yes.
Yes, thank you so much.
It's a yes from me.
It's a yes from me.
No.
famous. Thank you so much. I can't explain my emotion. I never expected Gordon Brothers. It's too much. Thank you so much. You did it!
Thank you. Oh, you were brilliant.
That's brilliant.
I love him so much.
I know, me too. It's like a dream. I saw this in like a YouTube. Some people got Gordon.
Yeah.
It's like,
yeah. And now it's you.
Yes. I'm you crazy.
Right.
See me. I'm invisible, but I'm here, all over here, right now. I'm standing right in front of one of the judges.
No. What? Did you touch that?
No, I didn't touch it. I don't know what's going on.
Amanda, please follow me up onto the stage. Come and take a seat.
I don't like it.
I'm just going to grab something from over here. Oh. Amanda, please hold the balloon by the stick. Balloons are the first thing that we all learn to lose, like the child that lost this balloon earlier today. They thought it was a gust of wind. It wasn't. It was me. I stole it to teach a lesson in loss. You might think it was rather mean to burst a balloon like that, but losing things is an important part of life. I'll show you what I mean. Amanda, the box on this trolley is the theater's lost property box. Please open the lid. Without showing anyone, Amanda, you will take one of the items and place it under the cloth on the trolley. Being invisible means I can't have material possessions of my own. So, instead, I just steal them from other people. And better yet, I can compel other people to do my bidding. Alicia, reach in with your right hand. Take a random object and hold it so no one can see what you chose. You are holding a secret in your hands. One that nobody could possibly know. Remember, you could have taken anything from that box, and yet Amanda knows exactly what you have taken.
Is she all right?
Amanda, I want you to take a deep breath and tell everyone what Alicia is holding in her right hand.
A dummy. No way.
This is weird.
But there's just one object left to identify. The one that you took at the beginning, Amanda. There is a piece of chalk on the trolley. Please pick it up and bring it to me over here. I'm standing in front of the blackboard. And let go of it, Amanda. I will take it from here.
How is it doing that?
Amanda, please lift the cloth and Show everyone what you put there. Please keep hold of those keys and take them back to your seat. You see, I've been amongst you these last few days. It's just that no one ever saw me.
Over 100 words that describe emotions that people can feel when they watch magic. Amanda, can you please join me up on stage? Yes. On your way up, can you please pick up a piece of paper and look at it? Don't let anyone else see and don't tell me.
Okay.
Can you please sit here? Start to mix this, we'll explain what's about to happen. With the help of my friends from the Magic Circle Young Magicians Club.
The Young Magicians Club.
We're going to do some magic that should hopefully blow your mind. Behind us is a framework containing 16 holes that fit a Rubik's Cube exactly. Each of my friends is holding a Rubik's Cube. Which, like you, they're randomly mixing. At any point, Amanda, I'd like to stop it from your Rubik's Cube. When you do, in a loud voice, please say stop and hold your cube high in the air.
Stop.
Now, Amanda, there are 200 quintillion ways that a Rubik's Cube can be mixed. All the cubes are mixed in a different way that nobody could possibly know. Everyone in the audience, if you've got a phone, can you please switch the torch on and hold it high in the air?
Sometimes I feel like throwing my hands up in the air. I know I can count on you. Sometimes I feel like saying, Lord, I just don't care. But you've got the love I need to see me through.
Remaining. Do you want to mix your cube some more or leave it as it is?
I'm going to leave it as it is.
Now, before this all began, when you had first sat down with me, I asked you to pick a word. What was that word?
It was love.
I can't love.